Okay, Bismillah, salatu wassalam ala Rasulullah. Let me share with you the AutoCADs. Okay, guys, before I start speaking about the main commands that will be covered today, inshallah, in our sixth recording or our recording for week six, we are still in the AutoCAD basics, and mainly we'll cover some of the commands in the draw list. The most important one that need to be covered, which is the hatching. Before I start the hatching, I have to go, of course, let's assume that we have different limits from the default one. Okay, I'm okay with this one, which is 200 and 200, 250 and 200. And then as usual, guys, I have to say zoom and then all, just to be sure that let's say again, zoom, enter. When the program asks me for the, I'm gonna say zoom all. And let's say that this A, let me move this one a little bit up, this shape by using the band. Okay. I don't know why the running is not working, but anyway, I can actually use the move. Take this one, highlight everything, and then move from here, this location to another location. Okay, guys. And let's make a little bit, draw the same shape, but in just make it bigger, any random shape. Okay, and here is another circle inside. Okay, and this is another shape inside. Okay, and let's see how we can apply our hatching command. First of all, you go to hatching, and you have to prepare your hatching limit to be consistent with the new limits. If you just go with the first option, with just picking up internal points, okay, let's say that I'm going to pick up a point inside. You see, guys, what will happen? You are not able to see the very dense hatching lines because the distance in between is not consistent with the new limits. So what I need to do, guys, before I go and select the hatching, I have to make setting for the hatching. First of all, this is the hatching style, okay, that usually we would use as a mechanical engineer, okay, ANSI 31, and then we go and control the this scale, the hatching scale. Let's make this one, let's try a big number, let's say 10. Okay, and usually, guys, the hatching angles is 45. The 45 from the AutoCAD point of view, it's called zero for the AutoCAD. So usually you have 45 hatching degree, or we have 135. The 45 means zero in the AutoCAD, zero angle, but for the 135, it should be how much? Of course, it should be 90. Okay, so there are two things to control: either to control the scale, change the scale, of course, and the other thing that need to be controlled is the angle. If I'm okay with the default angle, which is 45, just make this one zero. If I need to make it 135, just go and click on this A box and just change it from 0 to 90. Now I'm ready for the second step, which is picking up an internal point. Okay, once you come closer, you see, guys, there is a big difference between what we did before and what we are doing right now. But I still see that the distance in between is very small, so I can go back again before I apply my final step and make this one bigger. Let's make double, and then go back and pick up internal points. Here you go, guys, you can see very beautiful hatching lines. And the program is dealing with the hatching as one piece, one entity. How did I know this? Very simple, guys. Okay, let me get out of it. I'm done with the hatching, so just, I'm done with the hatching. And now let's show you why the program is dealing with this one as one piece or one part. Very simple, guys. If you look carefully, I'm gonna use erase. And now, if you come closer, it will erase everything. So, as usual, guys, if you need to erase some lines here or there, so it's very simple to go and say A and go to explode. And from the explode, you pick up the hatching lines, right click, left click, right click. And then you are ready to deal with each line separately. For example, I can erase this one, erase that one, erase that one, as you like. Okay, guys. So this is the hatching commands, and that's all what I need from you to know about the hatching. Now let's go to another command, another two commands. Like for example, you can draw a polyline by just bathing through different lines. Okay, but this is out of our business. But let me show you very quickly how can we draw this polyline. Yeah, let's assume, guys, that I'm gonna draw polyline passing through by the corners of this shape and the other shape. Okay, so again, you go to a draw, and then you click on that one, which is called the spline fit. Spline fit. Okay, so as usual, you go to the command line. It tells you to specify first point, next point, next point. It keep going asking like this until you get out of the selection, as we used to do by making right click. Okay, so I'm gonna click on that one. I'm going to specify the first point, let's say this intersection. See, guys, what will happen once I pick up the next point, then the program will give you a preview for how this a spline or how that polyline will look like once you go through the next point. So it automatically make its own a regression or line fitting on to come up with that a spline shape, which a I'm doing right now. If I'm done with my selection, that's it. I'm going to end up my selection by a left click and then right click. So this is very rare. We are very rare to use something like this, but in case you want to use it, just as I explained to you, it's very simple. You just go through the points that you need to let that spline go through. We also covered the, before the construction line when we divided our drafting area. And now it's time to speak about the next one, which is ray. Okay, so this is construction line extended to infinity from two sides, but you know the ray is extended to infinity from one side. How can I draw a ray? Very simple. You click on the ray, and as usual, the program will ask you to pick up the first point. Let's pick up any points here, guys. And now when it comes to the next point, he's asking you to define a point along that one. No need to define the length, because usually the length, it's the length of that point, but I'm not caring about the length. I have to care about the angle. So you just simply push tab to move to the second option, and let's put the degree 55 degree, and you can keep going like this. To finally to draw more than one ray. Yeah, bismillah. Okay, guys, as I said, the other two commands, the other commands that I'm going Well, yeah. As I mentioned, guys, here in this in this session, we'll cover also some commands in the draw list. One of these commands is how to draw a spline, and as you can see, just simply click on that spline, and then when the program asks you for the program will keep asking you for the points that this spline go through. So I can pick up any point, these points, that point. These points, the middle of this line, and so on until I finalize all my my selection, and then right click to get out of that spline. But as it's a very rare to used for us as a mechanical engineer, maybe for these people working in the architecture or civil people, you can use that that spline. Okay, the next one, guys, is to draw a ray. And as you can see, the ray is we can consider that the ray is the half of the construction line, because the construction is extended to the infinity from the two sides. This one is extended to infinity from one side. So by just picking up that icon or clicking on that icon, left bottom of the mouse, the program will ask you to specify the first point. You can pick up your point, and then when it comes to the next point, you can just put some any length, because the program is not caring about the because this one is infinity. So now the program is asking you to put another point on that line. So I can even skip the length, and what I'm worried about is exactly the angle. I have to exactly specify the angle, and then I succeeded to draw my ray. So okay, as you can see, guys, the ray is extended to infinity. So let me clear all these objects so we can be ready for the next commands. Executing the next command, select objects to be erased. I'm gonna say all simply, and just push enter, then enter. And now let's assume, guys, that I have a single line, or I have a circle, or I can even have that elliptic shape. It doesn't matter which method I used. I just need to erase an elliptic shape to show you how to implement the next commands. Okay. The second important command that I have to explain this session, guys, is how to divide your segment or your object into equal pieces. So I click on that icon, and then as usual, the program will ask you to select the object to divide. Let's say I'm gonna select this one. Okay. And then he's asking you to put the number of segments. So if I put like say 10, then he will divide that elliptic shape to 10 equal pieces. Okay. And now if I need to repeat the same thing for the circle, I can go to circle and then right click, and the program will ask me for a number of segments. Let's say I'm gonna divide this circle into 12 pieces. So I just simply put 12. Okay. Even the line, I can divide that line into equal pieces, and again number of pieces. Let's say if I said 5, then you can see that this 5. Okay, guys. Now somebody might ask me how your points looks like this. Actually, the regular point is a point. Yani when you plot any point in your drawing, it will look like a point, just one dot. Okay, but you still in our command, sometimes this one dot is not, you will not be able to see it. Okay, especially if this point was located and to a was used to divide the line. So how can I change the shape of my point or my node? They call it node in ODE. You can simply go to format. And again, guys, if you don't have that menu bar, you have to click on that down arrow there. Okay. And then you go all the way down until you can see the word, the statement, which is called the show menu bar. But now it's there, so no need to click it. The only option is to hide it, but I don't want to hide it. Anyway, getting back to our business, as I said here in that point, I'm going to show you how to draw how to change the point style. So you go to format, and then this format, there is something called point style. Okay, here is the rest of this is the default point, which is, as you can see, guys, if you look carefully, this is just single dots. Okay, this is how your points looks like. The second option, it's almost nothing. There is nothing drawn. It's just empty. Or you can say represented that by plus sign or cross sign or whatever out of this sign. Usually I prefer to have that shape or this shape. I just to make my life easy, and I can see clearly that point. You also have an option for changing the size. So this one it represents 5% of the available set size relative to the screen. So this is 5% relative to the screen limits. If you need to make it smaller, you just simply put this number 2. And then, as you can see, guys, all the points or all the nodes that I created before or I plotted before, it changed from 5% as a size to 2% as a size. If you want to make it bigger, that's fine. Just to go back to that list. So you simply go to format, and the format, you go to the point A style, and then from the point style, you start playing with this list. Then that's it. Okay. Now there is another way, guys, to make the division. It's not by giving the AutoCAD the number of segments. I can give the AutoCAD the length of the segment, and then the AutoCAD will take the total length and divide by that length of the segment, and it depends on the value of that segment. It will give you the number of segments. So let's try again. Let's assume, guys, that I have a line. Okay. And this time I need to divide that line, but not based on the number of segments, not equally divided, no, it's based on the segment length. So you go to the measure, the last one, which is called the measure, and then the program will ask you to select the object A that will be measured, or that will be divided into equal A pieces. And now, after I click, the program by default will ask you the last question, specify length of segments. So if you know the length of the segment, let's say my segment length is 3.5, for example, I can put 3.5, and then the program will, based on that A, the total length will divide by 3.5, and then it will end up by showing you the A, these segments, okay. From where usually the program starts for the division, it starts from the first point you located to draw your line. And if I start drawing, let me show you a clearer picture, guys, okay? Let's assume that this is my line. Remember, guys, I started from the left, up left to the A, lower A, right, okay? And now I'm gonna tell the program to make divide again. And this time I'm gonna select A, number of the measures the line, here you go. But I'm gonna give it big number, let's say 10. Okay, guys. So as you can see, guys, when you started the division, no, actually I said it started the division from the point, from the first point you plotted, you located on your screen to draw the line to the other one. No, what I said is wrong. Actually, the program starts the division from the last point that you located in your workspace to draw your line. Okay, so anyway, these are the base lengths. This from here to there it's 10. From here to there it's 10. And they keep going like this, and whatever is left, it will be left. And of course, the left part should have a length less than 10. Okay, so you see the difference, guys. You can divide your line based on the number of segments, or based on the length of each segment. Okay, so this is how to draw this one. Some of these commands actually will not be useful to go through this time, because they are very helpful when we talk about 3D. But let me show you very simple how to draw a helical spring. And of course, this is not part of the 2D. It's part of the 3D business, but let me show you how to draw a helix in case you are interested to know this one ahead. So you click on that icon. Of course, later inshallah, I'm gonna go through all of this, but inshallah, again, this will help me out if I'm dealing with 3D, and they are useless in the 2D. But let me very quickly, before I get out of this explanation, show you how to make helix, which is the helical spring. As you can see, guys, once you click on the icon, the program will ask you to specify center point of the base. Usually I'm gonna pick up any random point, and then the program is asking me to specify the base radius, okay, or diameter. So let's say the radius or diameter for this one, let's say 15, okay? And now the program is asking you to specify what? Top radius. You see, guys, imagine that you have that helical shape, a helical shape, and then that helical shape has a base and it has a top. So the length of the radius of the base should be given, and the radius of the top should be given. If they are the same, just simply click on enter. And now you have to be ready to answer the third last question, which is specify helix A height. Or you can simply pick up the number of turns, okay? So if you say it's helix height, which means the length of the spring. And usually I go with this one, the number of turns, عدد لفات الـ A in the spring, okay? So I'm gonna click on turns, and let's give this one, let's say 12 turns, and then specify helix height. This is the second A thing. I'm gonna say it's okay, my helix height, let's say 20, okay, and that's it. Now somebody might tell me, where is your helix? Where is your, and actually what you are looking at right now is the top of that A helical shape. And the only way, guys, to see that helical shape is to go and look at the A, at that, go and play with this box, and that will, inshallah, later in the 2D and 3D business will mainly deal with that box, and look at it from that side. Once you click on that side, this means that you are asking the program to get oriented such that you can see that you can see that helical shape, okay? So let's try this one. This one is not working, unfortunately. So I can go and use remember, guys, better to get out of this and go to 3D modeling. And then from the 3D modeling, I think I will be able to see this one. Even this one does not work. Something wrong, maybe, guys, with my setting. But anyway, how can I see this one exactly? Or how can I look at it to look like a 3D? Just simply, I have another thing called the orbit. And from that orbit, actually, I can keep rotating my shape until I can see okay, even the orbit is not working. I think, guys, I have something wrong with my AutoCAD. But anyway, once you go and change the direction, let's see if this one is also working. None of them is working now. I don't know what is the reason. Okay, if you click on that one, it's not there. Okay. So anyway, this actually helical shape, it's there, but what you are looking at right now, guys, is the top view. So you'll not be able to see the whole helical wire or spring. Okay, now let's get back to our still in the drafting and annotation. Okay, we almost covered the whole icons here in that list, the draw list. Now it's time to go to this list. Now we learned how to make move by just simply clicking on move, and when the program said ask you to select the object, you can let's say select that object. You can also select this object. You can select different types of A objects, and then right click to finalize your selection and be ready to answer the second question, from where you need to pick up these two things. I can randomly pick up any point, but I can pick up a point inside the A, on that elliptic shape, and then the program will ask you to locate the second point. It could be well-known points like the quadrant of this circle or the center of that circle based on your A selection, and then you can leave it there. What happened, guys? If you remember, if you see, there was also division A points, but these division points is just located on the top of that one, but the program is not dealing with them as if they are one piece. Okay, the program did not unite them, did not make them one single unit. Okay, this is why when we moved, we just moved the objects without moving the nodes themselves. Okay. The second option, guys, is to rotate. I can go to rotate and then simply make up the object, and then you can define the base points, and then you can define your rotation angle based on the orientation. I think we covered this one.